Hey y'all, so today we're playing my okay, what's good now? Let's continue this video so we continue. So our fucking dumbass sister here. Yeah, I'm talking to her. Her over here is crying over her husband getting drunk and fucking with other females. The bitch took him back. And the reason why I say that, because we beat the hell out of him. Put his hands on our sister. Now she is mad because we beat some sense into him, and now she's telling me to stay away. You hear, and I'm your brother, you know what? And this is the reason why I don't like this mission right here, bro, because you fake as hell. I'm the one gave you the money for your pay our mother for the good doctor. Now you use it on the wedding, so you use that on the wedding. Now I'm finding out that he putting your hands on you, he get a drunk and it's passing out on you, and now it's a problem. You know what? He got something on his ass. And y'all gonna see what I mean. Why I don't like this mission. Cigarette buds on the goddamn floor. Throwing up the fuck. Oh, what this nigga at? Hey, bitch, you know what this nigga at? Oh, you just chilling with some cigarettes, so you just land these niggas' palm.
Where's Eric?
Eric's in the kitchen, hun. But I think he's busy now.
I was too fucked up. Oh, this motherfucker here. Oh, you think you fucked this late? Hey, bitch. Come here, nigga. I'm gonna talk to you real quick.
Eric. What the fuck you think you're doing? I'm busy here, okay? Get lost. I think you should be busy taking care of your wife, asshole.
Facts. The fuck up out of here. Come here, bitch. I'm gonna talk to you soon.
You wanna
hit my sister, bitch? Oh, you motherfucker. Bitch, you wanna hit my sister? Huh? If you don't, she ain't shit. Get your ass up here. Your ass. Bitch.
Consider this a warning. You touch my sister again, I will fucking kill you. Alright?
Yeah.
From now on, you're gonna stay home. Stay off the dope, stop the drinking, and make sure she's fucking happy. If I ever hear she's not happy, I'll find you and finish the fucking job. You got it?
Yeah.
Now clean yourself. I would've told the nigga to clean himself up before he goes.
Okay, everybody, party's over. And there won't be any more partying with this guy again, ever. Unless you want me to come back and do the same to the rest of us. Got it?
And y'all niggas didn't hear all that shit, bruh. Get the fuck up out of here. And they playing the same music all over and over again. They're playing rock and roll shit. Let's go home. My sister better not call me. I might answer my goddamn phone. Cause I did what I had to do. My brother supposed to do that. It's the same thing with your wife. You're supposed to protect your wife. You're supposed to protect your sister. Any of the motherfucking neighbor. It's the same thing for your daughter, though. And like, come on, bro. Like, that shit makes sense, dog. Thank you. watch your ass before start calling me that bullshit. Talk about something hurting.
You know, he's been hanging out with a very bad crowd.
He apologized for everything, Vito. He promised he'll be good to me. It's all okay now. So you'll leave him alone, won't you?
You hear what this bitch say? You'll leave him alone, won't you?
Hey, whatever you want. But if he hurts you again, I'll kill him.
Listen to yourself, Vito. I don't know you anymore.
But...
Look... You stay away from us, you understand? Just stay away.
You're not my sister no more, bitch. You never have been my sister no more because your ass is stupid for fucking with a nigga like that. And second of all, I'm going to kill him if he did something to you. It's the same thing when you have with a daughter. It's the same thing when you have with a son. Someone did something to your son. It's like saying that someone did something to your daughter and your sister. If you have another sister, you watching out over her. So, I don't have a problem with this. So, she just... Fuck that in my face. I don't give a fuck. That's how you feel, that's how you feel. Don't call me when I end up dead, bitch. That's all I'm gonna say. When Vito end up dead, but Vito was alive, and he made it to Marvel 3, so... Let's get ready for bed. That shit. Oh, shit.
Torch the place! Do it!
Now!
Barn! You dig or cut! Barn!
Oh, these motherfuckers.
My house!
I'm broke as a mother... Man, these niggas, man. I'm broke. I don't have any money now, bruh. I don't even have any guns. I'm broke. That's a motherfucker, man. Get the fuck out the car. I don't like this mission either, bro. That's bullshit, bro. It took my money. It's gone and everything, bro. I ain't got no guns or nothing. I gotta get all my guns back. It's bullshit. They burned a nigga house down. My money is gone. That's the reason why I don't like this mission. Why my money is supposed to be gone for? Like, that's bullshit, bro. That shit just pissed me the fuck off, bro. Now that's where the fucking Joe house and shit, man. They burned my fucking house, man. Niggas, man, I swear, boy, I'm gonna kill this motherfucker, bro. Man, move your fucking piece of shit car, bro. Make it burn my fucking house, man. I don't got a house. Now I gotta live with Joe again. Now I got no money, I'm broke. This life is. If y'all never played the game Scarface, The World's Yours, this is what this mission seems like. Because we got fucking gangsters, gang members, gangsters, mafia gangsters, coming in your house, try to kill Scarface, Tony Montana, that you made it out of survive, to kill your tiger, he blew up your damn mansion, your mansion got on fire, and then you lose all your business and your money and your guns you have. So this is the mission like this. Now, this is pissing me off. Now I don't got nothing, man. Now I gotta get all those guns back. That's fucking crazy, bro. That's fucking crazy, bro. Shut the fuck up. Yeah, butt ass naked. Well, with drawers and shit. I'm barely fucking naked, but you know. T-shirts, tank top t-shirt with some damn boxers, drawers on. I'm not wearing Joe shit, bro.
Come on, Joe, don't tell me you're not home. Let's go. You better not be passed out. Come on.
Oh, are you barbecuing in your underwear?
Yeah. Can I come in?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, of course. I'll fix you a drink.
What the fuck?
Nice, ain't it?
What the hell happened to this place?
I spruced the joint up a little. What do you think?
Yeah, it's really, different.
Yeah, huh? I decorated it myself. So what the hell happened? Here, take this.
Those crazy fucking Mix.
What about it? What'd they do?
They tried to fucking kill me.
What?
Then they burned my fucking house down. Son of a bitch.
So what are you gonna do? You wanna go deal with the Mix right now?
Damn right I do.
All right, relax. Have a drink. Let me make a few phone calls. And, take a look at my closet. Unless you wanna go on a rampage in your skivvies.
Thanks. Thought you'd never ask.
I'm not wearing your goddamn clothes, Joe. I want my goddamn guns back.
Hey, it's Joe. Yeah, I know, but I need a favor. A bunch of Mix try to kill a good friend of mine tonight. Point this house down. I want to know who they are and where they're operating out of. Hey, you're gonna have a lot worse to worry about if you don't tell me. Mickey Desmond. Oh, he is. Well, that explains it. Where is he now? Yeah, I know the place. All right, thanks.
Where are we going?
The Hill of Tara, the Mick joint in Kingston. Come on, I'll tell you the rest of the car.
I need my motherfucking guns, man. I need my money back like I had it.
Come on, get in. So you heard anything about the Mix lately?
Nah, nothing. Why?
The Mix got themselves a new boss. Name's Mickey Desmond. There's a few other guys who want to take his spot. So he's trying to show everybody that he means business.
What the hell does that have to do with me?
Brian O'Neill. He was Desmond's cousin.
I should have known.
My money's on him being down at that shithole joint right now. Laughing it up with the rest of those fucking yo-yos.
Oh, let's get over there and deal with it.
That's the plan. Sounds like there ain't many of them left. So I guess we should just storm the place, surprise the shit out of them.
I like this plan. Assholes burnt my fucking house down.
Relax, we'll be there in a minute.
They don't be there in a minute. They burned my motherfucking house down with all my suits in
there. I almost forgot.
Yeah, if you got one, that'd be good. If not, I'll just beat them to death with my bare hands. It makes no difference to me.
Should be one in here somewhere. Here it is. Here you go.
Thanks.
What the fuck are you doing?
What's up your ass today?
They burned my fucking house down. I don't have none of my guns. They're gonna die today. They're gonna suffer in blood, in their own fucking blood, bro. In their blood bath. This nigga took my burned my fucking house with all my cars in there. My suits in my house and shit. Like,
what are you got, a diversion to red lights?
They gave me a fucking weak ass pistol and shit, bro. I don't even want that shit.
Ready, Vito? Come on, let's go get these fucks.
I told you, I chased him, but I lost. The coward ran away, but I'll find him. And when I do...
You were the one who ran away, asshole.
Fuck. You've got some balls.
Yes, I do.
Going in! We shot by my sister!
Wow, I didn't even get the chance to get my gun. Bro, that's bullshit, bro.
I told you. I chased him, but I lost. The coward ran away. But I'll find him. And when I do...
You were the one who ran away, asshole.
Fuck. You. You've got some balls.
Yes, I do.
You're fucking dead!
That's a classic song too, right there. I hope I don't get fucking copyrighted. Well, I get my money back at all, my guns, bro. Getting my guns back, so no, I'm not tripping, y'all. I'm not tripping.
Hey, you opening that door? Let's go. We're getting away.
All right, come on. You drive.
Fuck right now. I need this nigga to die. He burned my motherfucking house now. Shoot that cop something, bro. Shoot that nigga, though. Shoot him. I'm moving his ass. Hold up. Bitch. Fuck up. Who gives a fuck? You shouldn't even have fun. I'm about to die. But that's a good one.
Scared of that. Stupid fucks.
All right, get the fuck up out of here. Come on, Joe. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Fucking police, annoying. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, Joe, come on. Fucking police in the mighty fucking business, come on. Let's get the fuck up out of here, yeah.
Well, that takes care of that, huh?
Yeah, but don't give me my house back.
Don't worry, business is looking good. You'll have the cash for a new one real soon.
Yeah, sure as hell hope so.
All right, let's go back home.
So it's okay if I crash on your couch, right?
I could do one better than that. Here, take these keys. They're for Marty's apartment. I'm trying to get rid of it right now for his mother. So, you might as well use it while I do it.
Thanks. I guess.
Don't thank me, buddy. You're too old to be sleeping on my couch. Plus, I just bought the thing. I don't want you lousing it up. Marty's apartment's over in Oyster Bay.
I don't want to sleep on damn Marty's person.
You feel better now?
Not really. What we did back there doesn't even start to make up for it.
Hey, all that stuff they got boinked up is just things, Vito.
Just things. Hey, those white things. What do you think I do the shit we do anyway? It's to buy things. You know, suits, cars, broads, houses. Now I'm back to scratch. And all my damn cash was in that house, too. I promised myself I'd never be poor again. End up a fucking wolf rat with no mail.
Hey, I understand. Don't worry, we'll think of something. You'll be back on your feet in no time.
Nah, I want my motherfucker.
It's fucking here for you, isn't it?
I need my motherfucking money, Joe. No, Joe. I gotta get this. No, Joe. We gonna get there now. I want my fucking money. That fucking tripping. Fuck the red light right now. It's a video game. I want my fucking money. I lost everything. I lost my house and my money. My suits and my cars. My guns. And I got this weak ass fucking pistol again, bro. Even though that shit helps, though. Take this nigga Joe back to his fucking house.
Yeah, see you, I guess.
See you,
what
buddy.
The hell?
Sorry about tonight.
Go to Marty's old apartment. for Chinatown. This shit is ready. You gotta be fucking shitting me, bro. You gotta be fucking shitting me.
What a fucking dump.
Alright, man.
Cash for a hotel.
This don't make no motherfucking sense. All of my clothes, man. Like, bro, no, man.
Fuck, this is creepy.
Our good friend, chapter 12, Sea Gift. It's bullshit. Marty apartment, September 22nd, 1951.
My house burned to the ground, along with almost every penny I had. There was even some trouble with the cops, but Eddie took care of that. And since I didn't have any insurance, I had to live in this shithole of an apartment till I could get back on my feet. At least I managed to save Leo. He disappeared without a trace. I doubt Frank Vinci even knew where he went. And even though Henry failed to deliver on the contract, Eddie still brought him in when he heard Leo had skipped town. Me and Joe had a new partner.
Nah, I'll take you coming in, I'll be there in a minute, nigga.
Hey.
Listen, I'm setting up something big. I'm waiting to come in on it. If you're interested in hearing more, come meet me at Lincoln Park and bring a piece.
Okay. I'll see you there.
I see you at a garage. My car is still there. Good, good. Some bullshit.
Hey, here it comes.
Hey! What's up?
Hey, Vito.
Yo, yeah. What the fuck?
Right, listen, I've been doing some research on Carlos.
Yo, look at my head. So, the only reason he
because he was selling dope too, and he was stealing his customers. Now he just needs to get rid
of
him.
Bro, look at my head.
The one guy who could fuck things up and ruin his plan to become the main supplier for the whole city.
Look at my head, bro. Frank, why is my head over my mouth? Like, over my mouth.
I talked to a few people I trust.
Okay. So what does this have to do with us?
Of course, if he can do it, why can't we? A kilo of heroin costs $2,500 over in France. Then it's another $1,000 to get a hit.
This is horrible.
And,
like they're between my look at my head.
Just driving the stuff to the dealers. That's $7,500 profit a kilo.
Yeah, but what about Falcon?
Carlo won't find out. And even if he does, he'll just threaten us and demand the cut.
All right, but if Carlo's the only big supplier in the city, where are you going to buy the stuff from?
I'm way ahead of you. What do you two know about the Tongs?
The Chinks?
Some kind of organization for Chinese immigrants, right?
That's what I said, the Chinks.
Right, but it's also a front for their other operations. They run the Chinese quarter, and they keep to themselves. But some of them are interested in doing business with outsiders, and they need middlemen since most people are afraid to deal with them.
And we're the middlemen.
Yep. They'll give us 10 kilos to start.
For how much?
35 grand.
And we can sell it for...
110.
Nice.
Okay, well, where the hell are we gonna get our hands on 35 grand?
I know a loan shark. The Yid over on Palisade. I think a loan is 35, we give him 45 back. Now that means outtake is over 20 grand a piece. Not bad for just moving the shit from one place to another.
You know, who's gonna end up using this crap?
What do you care? As long as it isn't an outlet.
Of course, Vinci was right. Drugs are bad news, they kill people.
Look, only idiots do drugs. Deadbeats and losers. If they want to kill themselves so badly, I'd gladly help them out. Especially for 20 grand. I got buyers in the ghetto. They'll take care of the distribution. So we don't need to worry about that. Are you guys in or not?
I'm in. Come on, don't be stupid, Vito. 20 fucking grand in one afternoon.
When?
Right now. If we don't take the offer, the Tongs will just find somebody else.
Come on, Vito, it'll be a piece of cake.
Let's go see Bruno then. Vito, how about you run us all down there? He's on Palisade Street.
Okay, let's go.
Bullshit, man. Man, what's the point of me getting my hot thing, boss? You can't have a gun in here. Shut the fuck up. Broke as a motherfucker. Oh, I took so much fucking fun, man.
Get out of there.
Get out. Wrong car. I'm sorry, bro.
We're gonna see him.
His name's Bruno. He's one of the only guys in town who could do a loan this big.
What if he doesn't give it to us, then what?
Then the deal's off. But don't worry, I know this guy. He'll give us the money.
There ain't nobody else we can get this kind of money from?
There's three other guys I know of. But if you want to ask Carlo or Frank Vinci for 35 grand, be my guest.
Yeah, no thanks.
Who's the third guy?
He ain't in business no more. Somebody blew up a room full of his guys and shot him point blank in the face with a Tommy gun.
Oh, that guy.
Come on, we said we wasn't gonna talk about that.
All right, so, Henry, what is this guy, rich or something?
I think he gets his money from some of the bosses from out of town who sit on the commission.
Yeah? No shit.
Yeah, which is why we can't stiff the guy. Besides, we gotta keep this quiet.
Can we trust him?
Sure. All right, stop right here.
Yeah. You drive like my fucking grandmother, you know that?
Jeez. Relax, will you?
Hi, fellas. We're here to see Bruno.
Hiya, Henry. If you got guns on you, put them down there. I gotta search you.
Hiya, Bruno.
Hello, Henry. So, to what do I owe the pleasure of your company today?
I need 35 grand and $20 bills.
Oh, that's a lot of money, Henry. A lot of money. Tell me, why should I give that much to a small-time guy like you, huh? Convince me.
I got a sure thing. You'll have 45 by the end of the week.
What kind of sure thing?
Sorry, Bruno. That's a trade secret.
Then 45 is not enough. I'd be more comfortable with 65.
It's a bit steep, even for you. 50 is all I can do.
Henry, Henry, I have no guarantee I'll get my money back. And you have nowhere else to go. So, how about 60? Don't think of it as interest. It's more like my cut of the profits.
55, final offer. Anything more than that, it's not worth my time.
Deal. I'll give you $35,000 today, and you'll give me $55,000 by Friday. If you don't pay it back by then, the debt goes up by $10,000 every week.
You'll get it by Friday.
Okay. Isaac, prepare $35,000 in $20 bills. Now, you know I trust you, Henry, but if you screw me, remember these wise words from the Bible. And my wrath shall wax hot, and I will kill you with the sword, and your wives shall be widows, and your children fatherless.
Exodus, chapter 22, verse 24.
I'm impressed. You don't seem like the church-going type. But just remember, the money isn't mine. So even if you get rid of me, that doesn't get rid of your debt. So no funny business, okay, boys?
Sure, sure.
Thank you, Isaac. You want to count it, Henry?
I'll take your word for it, and I'll bring it back on Friday home where you are. Cut.
I hope so. Good luck, boys.
This damn warehouse.
Nice job.
Of course. I told you give us the dough, didn't I?
How come you know the Bible so good, Eddie? You read it or something?
Bruno always uses the same quote. I go to church on Sunday, so I ask the priest one time.
You go to church?
Yeah, and I can understand why you don't. They use big words, there's no hookers, and the food's lousy.
Yeah, that pretty much sums it up.
Jeez, I ain't been there since 45.
What? That time your mother made you go to confession?
Yeah, that time she smacked me for checking out some chick's school. I gotta rest her soul.
How about you, Joe? How long's it been?
Easter.
Ah, that ain't too bad.
1941.
I take that back then. You're going straight to hell.
Don't worry, I'll save seats for the boat boats. You know, I heard about a long shot named Bruno once. Must be the same guy.
Yeah, what'd you hear?
Well, you know Mickey the Crab, right?
What, the guy who cleans the bathrooms at Carlos joint?
Yeah, the guy who's only got a finger and a thumb on his left hand. Guess how that happened? I heard he owed a lot of money to some yid from Southport. Get my drift?
Oh, right. I get the picture.
Haha, don't worry. The Crab's a moron. Not like that's gonna happen to us. What do you got, an aversion to red lights?
All right, we're almost there. Drive through the gate and into the yard. Now just follow me. Hey, we got some business with your boss.
Follow me, gentlemen. Mr. Wong is expecting you.
Mr. Wong, Mr. Spectator. Everybody got the same animation to walk. Why? This is the point. This is the problem with my film. Why everybody got the same animation of walking? The males. Some males got different walks, but is it like me and Joe? Everybody else got the same walk and shit, bro. Cottage man got the same walk as us too.
Welcome, Henry.
Hello, Mr. Wong.
Let us get straight to business. Is your suitcase heavy enough?
See for yourself.
Yo, this is Yubang Zong, the person who made the money. You got 30,000.
All right, take it away and bring the goods. You're a good man, Henry. Here is your merchandise. Each bag contains 1 kilo. Each kilo weighs a little more than 2 pounds. Which one do you want to test?
Okay, we're good.
I'm glad. Next time, we can give you twice the amount.
It was a pleasure doing business with you, Mr. Wong.
The pleasure was all mine.
Knock it off. See how easy that was? Get back in the car.
Man, Joe plays fucking much, right?
All right, fellas, our part's over. Now we just gotta make the exchange and we're done.
Sounds good to me.
Where are we headed?
Hunters. I got it all lined up.
Hello, gentlemen.
Fucking
I think you have something for us. Drop the suitcases.
Bro, what the fuck?
My shoes.
Wait a minute, these guys ain't cops?
Kill the bastard! Shoot Vito!
Vito, watch our back!
Why do I gotta watch our back? Oh, he has a
gun.
Hold on.
I got it.
There's still too many of them.
Ah, shit, can't go back that way. Run!
Move your asses!
Why I gotta watch out back every time, bro?
Stay away from these windows, fellas. No sense staying up here. Vito, kick the door in.
Move, Joe. I'm not okay. What the?
Fellas, the hot pot's over. Now we just gotta make the exchange and we're done.
Sounds good to me.
Where are we headed?
Hunters. I got it all lined up.
It's some bullshit, bro.
Hello, gentlemen.
Fucking
I think you have something for us. Drop the suitcases.
My shoes.
Wait a minute, these guys ain't cops?
Kill the bastard! Shoot Vito!
Vito, watch our back! Back Vito, Vito!
Fuck!
Here comes more of them!
Hold on. I got them.
But there's still too many of them. Come on!
Oh, shit! Don't go back that way! Run!
Move your asses!
Vito, watch out back!
Kick the door in! Flank him, Vito. Come on, fuck you! Yeah, bring it on!
With this shit at.
Hi, fellas, the hot pot's
bro, up. This...
Now we just gotta make the exchange and we're done.
Sounds good to me.
Where we headed? Hunters. I got it all lined up.
Hello, gentlemen.
Fucking
I think you have something for us. Drop the suitcases.
Nice shoes.
Wait a minute, these guys are cops?
Kill the bastard! Shoot Vito!
Vito, watch our back! Going in! They teach you that neon? Here comes more of them!
Hold on. I got them.
Guys, there's still too many of them. Come on!
Shit, don't go back that way! Run!
No sense staying up here. Let's get down there.
Damn, brought his hand off. Damn, fucked his hand up.
I'm gonna get you sooner or later. All right, Vito, here we go. Yeah, you shoot like my sister.
Bye. That's why I love my four guns, man. Better get a bunch of money for doing this shit for real too.
Shit. That was fucking close.
It's not over yet. They're coming after us.
Fuck! Lose them!
Look at these mine! You're fucking dead!
Bro, and I died, bro. I'm not okay, Joe. Stop saying I'm okay. Ask him I'm okay.
It's not over yet. They're coming after us.
Fuck! Lose him!
Ask me and shit, I'm okay and shit. I'm not okay. If I was okay. Ooh, nigga, drive! I better get paid a bunch of money for this damn mission.
What the fuck was that, Henry?
No idea. Somebody else must have known about the deal. Those definitely weren't real cops.
Maybe it was the chinks trying to fuck us.
I doubt it. Look, I'll figure it out. But first, we gotta unload this stuff. Vito, take us to the old warehouse in Hunters.
Alright. Hope this deal goes better than the last one.
It will. Not like it will go any worse, right?
So who are we selling the stuff to?
A bunch of different guys.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. What do you mean a bunch of different guys?
A bunch of different guys. What did all that shooting back there make you deaf?
I thought you said we were just moving this garbage from one place to another.
Yeah, well, you'd make a lot more money if you sell it in smaller amounts.
Would have been really nice to know before I agreed to go in on this.
If I did, from the way you were talking back in the park, you probably wouldn't have.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, the best you can hope for right now is to spend the next 30 years of your life breaking your ass for Eddie and Colin before you either get bumped off or end up back in the can. The only time you're ever gonna see cash like this is if you stick your neck out. Besides, I ever steer you wrong.
Well, there was the OPA job. And that time we almost got killed when we whacked that fat fucking Sand Island.
All right, enough. None of that matters after today. Let's just get to Hunters. And don't worry, we're never gonna have to see these scumbags again after today.
Unless this turns into a regular thing for us.
Well, all right, let's just concentrate on getting through this one before we go making plans like that, all right?
Hey, I'm just saying.
Vito's right. Let's just get through the rest of the day. After that, smooth sailing, fellas.
That was fun. Territory of gang things with the black neighborhood.
Here we are. Let me do the talking. These are tough guys, so no wise ass comments. All right, y'all. Hey guys, how you doing?
Hey man. Come on in.
shit in my back. It's gonna fuck.
Shit! It's smoke. Fuck.
We did it! We hit the jackpot!
Hey, 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 take it easy. We're not done yet.
Lighten up, will you, Henry? What's the matter? All of a sudden, money don't make you happy?
After we pay back Bruno and you get your cut, then you can be happy.
All right, all right.
So this is my baby diamond ring. If that diamond ring don't shine, he gonna take it to a private eye. If that private eye can't see, he better take the ring from me. Oh, dear, they call her Nanny Go. They make a pretty baby of Sunday Go. Oh, dear, they call her Bellcat. They make a pretty baby of Sunday Hat.
Shit, that was a good cutscene. Chapter 13.
You ain't even gonna give me a tip?
You want a tip? I'll give you a tip. Don't let the door hit you in the ass on the way out.
Goddamn. Always the gentleman, huh, Joey?
Just get the fuck out of here already.
Wanna come join me?
Hey, I hope there's room for three in there.
But that's not enough money to buy my goddamn guns, man. Fuck it, we're gonna spend it. We're gonna spend it wisely. We'll be using it. We'll get these goddamn guns.
Barbaro's Bordello. You got the money, we got the honeys.
Vito, it's Henry. We got a problem.
What kind of problem?
Eddie paid me a visit. Carlo knows about the deal, and he sent Eddie to pick up his cut.
How much?
$60,000.
Fuck, that much? What are we gonna do?
I don't know. We don't even have enough left for Bruno. Meet me in the park. I don't want to talk about this over the phone.
Okay. I'll be right there. Joe, we gotta go. Now, Joe. I'll tell you on the way.
All right, girls, lock up when you leave. Me and Vito got business. So what the hell's going on?
That was Henry on the phone. Carlo found out about the deal.
Ah, shit. Does he know he was involved?
I don't think so. Let's talk about it in the car.
First, we went to my goddamn gun store. Fuck that. What you talking about, nigga? We went to the goddamn gun store. I need my shit, nigga. I don't give a fuck. Fuck all that right now. But anyway, we're going to stop for the red here, y'all. I hope y'all like this video. Make sure y'all like, subscribe. I love y'all. Peace.